If you want to know why this Shabbat was so important, why it should be kept as it was back in the days, it is because the blessings that come are amazing, but the curses are terrible things that happen if you do not keep the Shabbat. You will be laid desolate. Yahuwah said that if you do not keep a Shabbat, He will clear you from the land. He will destroy you so that His land has rest, that He, His people have rest. And it starts in Jubilees, the second Jubilees, verse 17. He goes, and He finished all His work on the sixth day, all that is in the heavens and on the earth, and in the seas and in the abysses, and in the light and in the darkness, and in everything. And He gave us a great sign, the Shabbat. We should work 6 days, but guard the Shabbat on the seventh day from all work. And all the angels of the presence and all the angels of sanctification, these two great classes, has bidden us to guard the Shabbat with Him in heaven and on earth. And He said unto us, behold, I will separate unto myself people from among the all the peoples, and these shall guard the Shabbat, and I will sanctify them unto myself as my people, and I will bless them as I have sanctified the Shabbat, and do sanctify it unto myself. Even so I will bless them, and they shall be my people, and they will be their Elohim. So, we get into it, and even the angels, these creatures, these things that Yah has created, are even more powerful than we are, and they follow the Shabbat. But we, as weak people, as fragile beings, we defy our Creator, we defy Yahuwah, and we do not, listen, he says, we snub Him when we do not keep the Shabbat. When we go on Sunday worship, we worship the sun god. We are snubbing Him. We are telling Him we want to be cursed. We do not love Him. If you love Him, keep His Shabbat. It is very good for you. It's rest. You get, your mind gets refreshed. You're ready for the week. You can go work on Sunday. Do whatever you want. And it is really good. So, for the people that do not keep the Shabbat, it is a very simple thing to do. You just cook your meals the day before, you put it in a crock pot, and you go to sleep, you put all your stuff ready, you get all your stuff ready, you don't do anything, you don't do any work that day, you just read your Bible, you spend time with your Creator, if you have family, have fellowship with your family, and you feel rested, you feel good, and those are some of the blessings that come with it, because when you feel these blessings, you'll understand that Yah is blessing you for keeping His Shabbat, keeping what He said to do. Because even if His messengers, His angels are doing it, we should be doing it even more so.